हेलो, आई एम स्वाति जाधव फ्रॉम डी वाई पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग अकुडी पुणे। दिस वीडियो इज द वीक 4 एक्टिविटी अंडर इंटरनेशनल एफडीपी ऑन एनवायरमेंट एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी। द टॉपिक चोजन इज CO2 एमिशन ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर गैस सेंसर। द कंटेंट ऑफ वीक 1 वीडियो आर द कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्किंग एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर गैस सेंसर अलॉन्ग विद डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ इट्स सस्टेनेबिलिटी such as reuse, stability and calibration are appraised. In week 2, different ISO standards with respect to construction and application of gas sensor for environment monitoring, safety, process control and indoor or cabin air quality are analyzed. After learning through this video, student will analyze the ISO standard of gas sensor with respect to construction and its application, design the gas sensor with respect to life cycle assessment, examine the features to design sustainable sensor, justify the energy consumption with respect to carbon emission. The ISO standards related to semiconductor gas sensors construction and application are listed below. The standard for electronic device are applicable for the gas sensor, that is CE and UL standard. Air quality measurement standards are based on the comparison and determination of uncertainty measurement. Indoor air quality standards for measurement method and air quality management. While using gas sensor as a smart transducer, it should follow networking and information model. Two standards are defined for interior air quality of road vehicles related to automotive sector. Smoke alarm standard include test methods, performance criteria and manufacturing instructions. Consider life cycle assessment of electronic device, which is also applicable for semiconductor gas sensor. The first process is extraction of raw material. This step contributes 26% of carbon emission in life cycle product. Next stage is design, which is referred for manufacturing the product. Then the product is transported to the customer or user. The product remains operational with proper use and maintenance. Once the service life of product over, there are three options: reuse, recycle and dispose. The product sent for disposal, if get repaired, can be reused, and if the product could not get repaired, then it can be recycled for material extraction. The sustainability, which implies extended interval for maintenance. The sustainability, which implies extended interval for maintenance, depends on various factors like warranty, stability, calibration and power management. As per product specification, the warranty period of the gas sensor is around 2 years, which is equivalent to sensor life of 20,000 hours. The semiconductor gas sensor provides sufficient stability against harsh environment. The harsh environment implies high velocity gas stream and presence of aggressive compounds like SO2 or NOx. The calibration interval of gas sensor is around 18 months. The auto calibration facility can be incorporated in the sensor design. There are different options available for powering the gas sensor. First option is to use a pair of dry cell, second option is plug-in facility and third option is use of rechargeable lithium-ion battery. Sustainability computation. From the long-term experiment, it has been observed that semiconductor gas sensor is sustainable for 18 months for routine operation of 24 hours a day in environment monitoring application. After 18 months, the calibration is required. Plug-in design will not interrupt operation of gas sensor as compared to battery recharge design, but the choice depends on the application. gas sensor with rechargeable battery with the specification of voltage as 3.7 volt and current rating as 1200 milliampere hour. Multiplying voltage by current, the wattage will be 4.4 watt. Gas sensor with plug-in facility have the wattage of 1.7 watt. If we use the gas sensor for 24 hours a day, the energy consumption will be 3.1968 kilowatt hour for gas sensor with rechargeable battery and 1.224 kilowatt hour for gas sensor with plug-in facility. Carbon emission by electricity is calculated as energy consumption multiplied by emission factor. Emission factor for India is 0.82 kg per kilowatt hour. So for rechargeable battery gas sensor, it is estimated as 2.621376 kg of CO2, and for gas sensor with plug-in facility is 1.00368 kg of CO2. In case of rechargeable battery, the period for which charging lasts depends upon the functionality of gas sensor. Energy consumption due to different features of semiconductor gas sensor are elaborated in this flowchart. Consider the LED facility. Green LED will indicate safe air quality, while red LED will indicate unsafe air quality. So at a time, only one LED will glow. Each LED will consume 20 milliampere. So as per specification of lithium ion battery, that is 1200 milliampere hour, the charging will last for 60 hours. This is computed as 1200 milliampere hour divided by 20 milliampere. So it becomes 60 hours. If we incorporate alarm facility along with visual indication, then total current will become 90 milliampere for alarm plus 20 milliampere for LED. So 110 milliampere. Thus charging will last for 10 hours. Suppose gas sensor is designed for showing air quality on LCD display. As per specification, current consumption is 1.5 microampere per centimeter square. Consider display size of 128 by 64 square inch. Then it will consume 80 milliampere current. Incorporating all above features, the charging will last for approximately 6 hours. Considering additional features such as wireless transmission of data to smart devices to create IoT network, there will be further consumption of current and the charging will last for less than 6 hours. From the construction of the gas sensor, the percentage of material is represented in the pie chart. With replaceable parts, the sensor can be reused and the service life is extended. And the sensor can be sent for raw material extraction. The bar chart represents comparative study of life cycle energy for overseas production and local production. The logistic emission contribute more in case of electronic devices while estimating life cycle energy. Let's account logistic emission for overseas production and local production from carbon footprint calculation. Consider the case of product manufactured at USA. Three-letter word IATA code is used to represent the transportation from USA to Pune. Total carbon footprint will be 5.25 tons of CO2 emission. Consider second case of local production. Say the electronic device is manufactured at New Delhi and transported to Pune. If transportation is by roadway, then total footprint is 0.15 tons of CO2, and by railway it is 0.07 tons of CO2. Carbon emission reduction during transportation. It is possible by efficient packaging and by mode shift. For efficient packaging, reduce the package weight and use foam shipping pallets. For transportation mode, opt for shipping by ocean instead of air and prefer railway over roadway. These are the references. Thank you.